My dear children, welcome back to my channel, Happy Learning Mathematics. So today we will be learning the 24th lesson, which is location of a place. So today under this lesson, we will be covering two topics, which are finding the direction. That means with a use of the diagram or the sketch, we are going to mark the location of the place using the main directions. Second one, we are going to illustrate a location with a sketch diagram. So if a sketch has been given, so how to if a location has been given, how to denote that in a sketch diagram. So these are the two topics which we are going to cover, which is very easy, and we'll be able to understand it really easy as well. So let's move on to the lesson now. So the first topic we'll be covering here is finding the location of a point. So first, you all know what are the main directions are. Am I right? They are north, east, west, and the south. Okay, and the sub directions are, this is northeast, southeast, this is southwest, and this is northwest. Okay, so we are going to write the location based on the main directions only. Another important thing you need to know here is, now the angle between the main directions are 90 degrees. Am I right? Between all four main directions, it's going to be a right angle. So they are 90 degrees. The angle between these two, north and northeast, are going to be 45 degrees. Okay, so it's exactly in the middle of north and east. So it is going to be 45 degrees. So we are going to mark the location using the main directions and the angles formed by it. Okay, so when can we mark a location? Now let's take now the location which lies on a flat surface. Let's consider this as a flat surface. Like a land, it can be a floor. So we are going to plot the two different places or two or more different places using this diagram. For example, let's assume that this is your house and this is a shop beside your house. So we are going to indicate this in a sketch. So we are going to mark the location of the shop related to your house. In order to do that, they will give you the main directions drawn at your house. Okay, so this is the north of the house. And this is your house, the point of your house. Now I'm going to join these two locations, and they might have given you the angle formed in between these two. Okay, so let's assume this as 75 degrees. Okay, so now how do you indicate this location? Okay, so always you remember, we are going to relate a location in respect to another point only. So here it is your house. So this is known as north to east. So in between north, this shop is in between the direction north and east of your house. So we will be indicating it as north to east, 75 degrees. Or else we can say, we can read this as shop is located 75 degrees east of north. And this can be denoted in short like this. Did you all understand? Now let's look at another example. So in order to explain that, now I'm going to write a location with the relevant to the point O. So I have fixed a thread in here. Now we need the main direction drawn from the point O. So this is north, this is east, This is west and this is the south. Am I right? Now let's take few locations from here. So let's say this as location X and this as Y, and here it's P and this one as Q. And also they might have given you the angle formed in between them. Okay, so let's assume this has been given as 50 degrees, this one as 65 degrees, this one as 45 degrees, and this one 70 degrees. Okay, right. Now we are going to mark the locations with the relevant to the point location O. Okay, so let's move on with the first one, which is location X. So as you can see, remember you must always begin to write the location with the directions north and south. Okay, so this location is situated in between the directions north and east. Am I right? As you can see, this is in between north and east. So the way we start this is, it is the direction of 50 degrees east from north. So we write it as north to east, 50 degrees. Okay, the second example. Now look at here. As I told you, we should begin with the direction south. So it lies between south and east, but the angle of this has been given. So what we should do here is we should find the angle from south to this specific location. So you all know that angle formed in between the main directions is 90 degrees. So how do we find this angle? By subtracting it from 90. So which is going to be 25 degrees. Am I right? So now you can write the location south to east. It's 25 degrees. Do you understand? Now the next one. Right. Now this is exactly in the middle. Why it's 45 degrees. So you can write this in two ways. I'll explain to you that. Now the location of P can be written. So you should start from south, south to west. In between south and west, it's in angle of 45 degrees. And also you can write it as it lies exactly on the direction southwest. So this is also correct. Why? Because it's exactly in the middle of these two directions. So here you can use either of the method, one of the method. At last, the location of Q. Okay, so the location of Q is going to be from north, you should measure. So from north to west, the angle between these two has not been given. But you can find it out by subtracting this from 90. So this is 20 degrees. Am I right? So you can write it as north to west, 20 degrees. So that's how you mark a location with relevant to a given point. Okay. Now let's look at another example. So let's assume this is your house which has been denoted with H. So I'm going to write the location of a shop and a tree with relevant to your location of your house. So there should be the main direction drawn at your house. Okay, so northeast, western, south. So the shop is situated somewhere over here and the tree is here. This is the shop and this is the tree. And here they have given you the distance of the two locations as well. Okay, it is at 500 meters of distance, and the distance between your house and the tree is going to be 100 meters. So now how do we write this? Okay, so this is 80 degrees and this has been given as 10 degrees. First, let's write the location of the shop. So the shop is 500 meters from north to east, 80 degrees. So this is how you write. It's very simple. Now next, the location of the tree. So it's between south and west. The angle from south to west has been given as 10 degrees. And it lies at the distance of 100 meters from south to west, 10 degrees. So do you understand? So if the distance has been given, you can indicate that as well when you write the direction of the location. Now let's move on to our second topic, which is illustrating a location with a sketch. So if you understood the first half of my lesson, which is the first topic, you will be able to do it real easily. Okay, so let's assume they have given you a direction of a location like this. From north to east, 40 degrees. So unless they have given you a point or name of the location, you can mark it as with any letter. So I'm marking it with O. So I'm going to draw the location with relevant to the point O. So you should mark the main directions from this point O. So now let's mark this. So it lies between the directions north and east at 40 degrees. So you can mark it in this way. Do you understand? To give you another example, now they are giving you the distance between the location as well. So it lies at 10 kilometers from south to west, 80 degrees. Okay, now let's draw the diagram. So this is your point O, location O, the main directions. So the location is between south and west. So it will come in between these two directions at 80 degrees. So it must be measured from the south direction. So it should be somewhere like here. Mark it as 80 degrees. And since they have given the distance, you should mark it on top of the line. So this is how you indicate a location to a specific point. Did you all understand? So in order to give you a clear understanding of this lesson, I'll be doing two exercises extracted from your textbook. So this question has been extracted from your textbook. So let's move on to the question. Kavinda traveled 20 meters from the point O in the direction of east from north 44 degrees. And from that point he traveled 20 meters in direction of east from south 45 degrees. Now the first question from that is draw the sketch. So as they are starting the location, beginning to travel from the point O, so you should indicate the four main directions from the point O. So north, east, south and west. Okay, so now first he is traveling 20 meters from O in the direction of east from north. So it should come lie between these two direction at the angle of 44 degrees. So it will be coming like this. Am I right? So now after this, since they have given us the distance from it as well, you should indicate that on the line itself. Okay. Now, from that point, he is traveling 20 meters in the direction of east from south at the angle of 45 degrees. So, from this particular point, we should draw the next location. So, for that, we need to draw the four main directions first, which is north, east, south and west. Okay. Now, he is traveling south to east. That means in between these two line directions, east and south, is traveling 45 degrees. That means exactly the southeast direction. The distance is 20 meters. So, same length of this. And this is the angle of 45 degrees. Do you all get it? So, this is the destination now. Some children do get the doubts as whether they need to measure and draw the angle here. No, you don't have to, because it is a rough sketch. So you don't have to measure. It has to be in a not have to be accurate, but similar to the distance. So the angle they have given. Okay. So here 20 meters, of course, you cannot measure it, right? So you can simply draw rough sketch and mark the relevant data onto it. That's all you need to do. Right. So we have done the first question, which is they have asked us to draw the sketch. Now this is the sketch for your first question. Now this is the second question from the same question which I did before, which is in which direction is Kavindu now with respect to O. So they are asking of the destination direction from this point O. Okay, so as you can see here, right, he is at the direction of east. Here, from here, this is the final point. So he is at the direction of east. So that is going to be the answer. Okay, so that's all under this lesson, children. So if you have any doubts from this lesson, you can ask from the comment section.